Welcome back to the Hollywood Inside 1960s channel. Today, we will delve deep into the lives of stars who once had it all but faced painful failures, ultimately losing almost everything and leaving the entertainment industry. From financial difficulties to personal issues, or simply losing favor in the ever-changing world of fame, their stories are not only intriguing but also serve as cautionary tales. Join us as we explore the tumultuous journey of famous individuals who endured tragic losses. Now, let's get started. Number 20. Connie Stevens, born Concetta Rosalie Ann Ingoglia on August 8, 1938, in Brooklyn, New York. She gained fame in the entertainment industry at the age of 16, particularly for her role as Cricket Blake in the television series, Hawaiian Eye. With her beauty and talent, Stevens quickly became a small screen icon. However, her career took a sudden downturn when she became embroiled in a famous controversy in 1978. Connie Stevens was rumored to be dating baseball player Joe DiMaggio, the ex-husband of Marilyn Monroe, despite a nearly 20-year age difference. The rumors led the public to turn away from Stevens, viewing her as a third party, disrupting a family's happiness. Her acting career suffered significantly after this scandal. Despite facing challenges, Connie Stevens remains a talented artist with significant contributions to the entertainment industry. Number 19. Barbara Stanwyck, born Ruby Catherine Stevens on July 16, 1907, in Brooklyn, New York. Stanwyck quickly rose to fame with roles in films such as Double Indemnity, 1944, and Stella Dallas, 1937. In 1935, at the peak of her fame, Stanwyck unexpectedly divorced her husband, Frank Fay, after 7 years of marriage. The divorce proceedings were contentious, with accusations flying between the two. According to the divorce papers, Stanwyck accused Fay of physical abuse and verbal insults, even threatening to kill their 4-year-old daughter. In contrast, Frank Fay denied all accusations, claiming that Stanwyck had betrayed their marriage. The incident garnered media attention, and the public was appalled by Stanwyck's actions. Her career suffered a severe decline, and her former status was never fully restored. Despite the challenges in her career after the scandal, Barbara Stanwyck's contributions to the entertainment industry are undeniable. Number 18. Dean Paul Martin, born Dino Paul Crosetti Jr. on November 17, 1951, in Santa Monica, California, was an actor, singer, and model. He was the son of the famous singer Dean Martin. Dean Paul Martin gained fame in the 1970s when he joined the pop group Dino, Daisy, and Billy. He was also known for roles in TV shows like Misfits of Science and The Love Boat. Despite personal challenges, such as serving in the U.S. Air Force and becoming a pilot, Dean Paul Martin tragically died in a plane crash on March 21, 1987, near the San Gorgonio Mountains in California during an air race. This incident marked the end of a promising but short-lived life of a multi-talented artist. The public deeply mourned the loss of a figure who was expected to lead a lavish and glamorous life but lost it all. Number 17. Anne Bancroft, born Anna Maria Luisa Italiano on September 17, 1931, in the Bronx, New York. She was a talented and versatile actress, widely known from the 1950s until her passing in 2005. Anne Bancroft garnered public attention for her role opposite Marlon Brando in On the Waterfront, 1954. However, controversy surrounded her when she chose to star in The Graduate, 1967, and portrayed the infamous seductress Mrs. Robinson. Despite widespread recognition, this role sparked controversy and mixed opinions, almost jeopardizing Bancroft's standing in the entertainment industry. Though Bancroft's career faced turbulence due to the notoriety of The Graduate, she maintained her class and reputation in the film industry. Number 16. Liv Ullmann, born Liv Joanne Ullmann on December 16, 1938, in Tokyo, Japan, is a renowned Norwegian actress and director. Liv Ullmann rose to fame in the 1960s through collaborations with director Ingmar Bergman in iconic films such as Persona, 1966, and Cries and Whispers, 1972. However, Ullmann's personal life faced challenges when she embraced the role of a single mother, experiencing the pain of tumultuous relationships. These struggles drew public attention, leading to speculation and conflicting opinions. Some viewed her as a home wrecker, disrupting the happiness of another's family, preventing her from finding complete happiness. Despite personal hardships, Liv Ullmann remains a significant figure in world cinema, contributing greatly to both cultural and artistic landscapes. Number 15. Leslie Gore, born Leslie Sue Goldstein on May 2, 1946, in Brooklyn, New York, was a famous singer, songwriter, and music producer, known for her hits in the 1960s. Leslie Gore gained widespread recognition at the age of 16 with her debut song, It's My Party, 1963. However, in the 1970s, her music career waned due to changing public tastes. Additionally, Gore faced challenges in publicly addressing her sexuality as a lesbian during a time when it was not widely accepted, attracting criticism. Despite difficulties in her music career and personal life, Leslie Gore maintained her artistic spirit and continued to work in the music industry. Number 14. Eva Bartok, born Eva Marta Sok Ivanovics on June 18, 1927, in Budapest, Hungary, became famous in the film industry, starring in several notable films such as The Crimson Pirate, 1952, and Operation Amsterdam, 1959. With her captivating beauty and excellent acting talent, she garnered attention and established her name in the world of cinema. However, Eva Bartok's personal life began to experience heartbreaking changes. Her romantic relationships, especially her marriage to director John Gillerman, faced difficulties and ultimately ended. This attracted media attention, putting her in a position to face criticism and controversy. Despite personal challenges, Eva Bartok's talent and contributions to the film industry remained highly regarded. Number 13. Dorothy Dandridge, born Dorothy Jean Dandridge on November 9, 1922, in Cleveland, Ohio, was a renowned actress and singer who became an icon in the 1950s. She gained widespread recognition for her role in the musical film Carmen Jones, 1954, earning an Oscar nomination for Best Actress and becoming the first African-American woman to receive such a nomination. However, Dorothy Dandridge faced significant challenges due to the unfair treatment of people of color in the entertainment industry and society at the time. She struggled to find diverse and quality roles, both professionally and personally, facing issues of marriage and finances. Despite the heartaches in Dorothy Dandridge's life, she left a strong legacy with significant contributions to American arts and culture. Number 12. Sandy Dennis, born Sandra Dale Dennis on April 27, 1937, in Hastings, Nebraska, was a talented actress known for her unique and diverse acting style. She gained fame for her role in the play, A Thousand Clowns, in 1962, winning a Tony Award for Best Actress. Sandy Dennis's film career reached its peak when she won an Oscar for her performance in Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf, 1966. However, she was also known for her reserved and cautious personal life, creating a mystery surrounding her life. Public speculation arose due to Dennis never marrying, nor publicly disclosing any romantic relationships. She lived alone, secluded with her pets. Some believed that Sandy Dennis could not integrate into Hollywood and would eventually leave the entertainment industry. However, her contributions to the art of acting were still considered significant and unique, leaving a profound mark on film and stage history. Number 11. Susan Oliver, born Charlotte Gurka on February 13, 1932, in New York City, gained fame for her roles in numerous films and TV shows during the 1950s and 1960s. She achieved success with her role as Anne Howard in the TV series Peyton Place and in films like Butterfield 8 Inches, 1960, and The Green Hornet, 1967. Susan Oliver's personal life faced challenges and fluctuations. During her childhood, she witnessed her parents' divorce, and her mother passed away when she was only 10 years old. She had to live with a strict father. Due to difficult circumstances, Susan Oliver took on various jobs from the age of 12, including working in restaurants and as a street vendor to make a living. In the entertainment industry, she experienced a period of hardship, struggling to find a direction for development. However, driven by passion and diligence in the arts, Susan Oliver left a diverse and impressive legacy in the entertainment industry. Number 10. Susan Hayward, born Edith Marener on June 30, 1917, in Brooklyn, New York. Susan Hayward was a distinguished actress of the golden era of Hollywood, having won an Oscar for Best Actress. However, her personal life also experienced many ups and downs. Susan Hayward went through 5 failed marriages, including 2 divorces from Jess Barker. Her tumultuous marital life attracted public attention. Many criticized her for this destructive lifestyle, and the public gradually turned away from their idol. Although Susan Hayward's career was affected, the significant contributions she made to the art of acting cannot be denied. Number 9. B.B. Anderson, born Berit Elizabeth Anderson on November 11, 1935, in Kungsholmen, Sweden. Famous from the early 1950s, B.B. became an icon of Swedish cinema, especially through her collaboration with director Ingmar Bergman. She showcased excellence in works like The Seventh Seal and Persona, gaining global recognition. B.B.'s life faced fluctuations when she was rumored to have a complicated romantic relationship with director Ingmar Bergman in the 1960s, despite both being married. Though mere rumors, it affected the public perception of both artists. Her career almost stagnated, lacking the previous momentum. Despite challenges, B.B. Anderson retained respect from audiences and colleagues, recognized for her talent and significant contributions to world cinema. Number 8. Lee Remick, born Lee Ann Remick on December 14, 1935, in Quincy, Massachusetts. She gained fame in the 1950s and 1960s with outstanding performances in works like Days of Wine and Roses and Anatomy of a Murder. The pinnacle of Lee Remick's acting career was shaken when she had to confront a battle against her own substance abuse issues, including alcohol and stimulants. Images and personal information about these events shocked and stirred controversy in the public, posing a significant challenge to her career. Although Lee Remick's personal life faced heavy challenges, her undeniable talent and contributions to the art of acting remain highly esteemed. Number Number 7. Claire Bloom, born Patricia Claire Bloom on February 15, 1931, in London, England. She became one of the world's renowned actresses from the 1950s, reaching the height of her career with works like Limelight and The King's Speech. Claire Bloom's personal life experienced turmoil, entangled in complex romantic relationships and divorces. Detailed information and private images brought her personal life into the spotlight, creating controversial images in the public eye. Although Claire Bloom's career had its fluctuations due to personal life, her outstanding talent continued to be highly praised in the film industry. Number 6. Angie Dickinson, born Angeline Brown on September 30, 1931, in Culm, North Dakota. She rose to fame in the 1950s, with a remarkable career development through roles in works like Rio Bravo and Policewoman. Angie Dickinson's personal life faced challenges with rumors and suspicions regarding her romantic relationships. These rumors created controversy, influencing the public perception of her. Despite personal challenges, Angie Dickinson, with her talent and charisma, remains an icon in the entertainment industry, leaving a strong impression on the audience. Number 5. Natalie Trundy, born Natalie Trundy Donner on August 5, 1940, in Boston, Massachusetts. She was a famous actress and director, particularly known for her roles in the Planet of the Apes science fiction film series. Natalie Trundy garnered public attention from the 1960s, especially with her involvement in the Planet of the Apes project. She had the honor of playing roles with complexity, but the peak of her career did not escape personal turbulence. Natalie went through 4 broken marriages, including 2 divorces from actor Arthur Franz. This attracted media attention. Due to numerous love scandals, Natalie's career suffered severely. She received fewer significant roles and gradually withdrew from the entertainment industry. Despite personal hardships, Natalie Trundy remains an influential artist, leaving her mark on the art of acting and the film industry. Number 4. Tuesday Weld, born Susan Kerr Weld on August 27, 1943, in New York City. She began her acting career at a very young age and quickly became one of the prominent stars in the film industry, especially in the 1960s. Throughout her long-lasting career, Tuesday Weld's private life was quite complicated with many ups and downs. Weld went through 6 failed marriages, including a tumultuous relationship with singer Dudley Moore. Her love affairs were often the focus of media attention. The mysterious private life of Tuesday Weld attracted public curiosity and media attention. There were rumors that she had struggled with sleeping pills and alcohol to relieve pressure. Despite the personal challenges faced by Tuesday Weld, her talent and contributions to the art of acting cannot be denied. Number 3. Carol Lynley, born Carol Ann Jones on February 13, 1942, in New York City. She was a famous actress who started her career at a very young age and quickly became an icon of the 1960s. Carol Lynley was known for her roles in works like Blue Denim and The Poseidon Adventure. Her outstanding performances brought her an Oscar nomination and maintained a strong position in the film industry. Carol Lynley's personal life went through fluctuations and challenges, with rumors and controversies surrounding her personal relationships. These issues created a tension and controversy in the public eye. Despite personal difficulties, Carol Lynley remained an influential artist, leaving a lasting impact with her excellent contributions to the film industry. Number 2. Eva Gabor, born Eva Gabor on February 11, 1919, in Budapest, Hungary, and passed away on July 4, 1995, in Los Angeles, California. She was a renowned actress, singer, and model, known for her sophistication and diverse talent. Despite being a small screen star, Eva Gabor's personal life often became a topic of discussion in the media. Eva Gabor was married 5 times, and all ended in failure. Her failed marriages often stirred up media attention with many scandalous rumors. Furthermore, in 1983, she was seen dating investor George Sanders, a man 25 years her junior. This relationship was condemned by the public. Despite her personal struggles with her talent, Eva Gabor could not be denied the impact she left on the entertainment industry over many decades. Number 1. Carol Baker, born Carolina Piekarski on May 28, 1931, in Johnstown, Pennsylvania. She was an actress with a rich career, gaining fame in the 1950s and reaching the peak in the 1960s. Carol Baker shocked the film industry with roles in works like Baby Doll and Giant. Her versatile talent was highly appreciated, earning her awards and prestigious nominations. Carol Baker's personal life faced turmoil when she got involved in a love scandal with actor Marlon Brando in 1965. Both were caught in a romantic encounter on Brando's yacht. The incident shocked the public and became a hot topic in the media, attracting attention and controversy. Despite the personal hardships in Carol Baker's life, her outstanding contributions to the art of acting continue to leave a lasting legacy in the history of cinema. Thank you for joining us on this interesting journey through the transformations of iconic figures. If these stories intrigued you, don't forget to hit the like button, share this video with those who love compelling narratives, and subscribe to Hollywood Inside 1960s for more riveting content. Your support fuels our passion for unraveling the untold stories of these influential personalities. Stay tuned for more revelations, and until next time, keep the curiosity alive. See you soon on Hollywood Inside 1960s.